Hello dear, welcome to all. Say, in our oxoacids of phosphorus, okay? In oxoacids of phosphorus, we have to discuss some important oxoacids of phosphorus, that is, say, phosphinic acids. First we will discuss here what? Phosphinic acid. Okay, and this phosphinic acid, okay, we can also call it hypophosphorus acid. Hypophosphorus acid, that is H3PO2. It is what beta? H3PO2. So we will first do the preparation of what is your phosphinic acid or hypophosphorus acid. So see here, in the preparation of this acid, okay, so when your barium hydroperoxide is react with H2SO4, see here, in the preparation reaction, your barium hydroperoxide H2PO2 twice, when it reacts with H2SO4, it gives what? Yes, it gives your BSO4 plus 2H3PO2. Like that, your preparation of what? Yes, preparation of your H3PO2. Okay. Now, see here, whether it is monobasic acid or dibasic acid, this we deal on the base of structure. So, see, as like this, your structure H3PO2. What beta? H3PO2. See here, H3, say 1, 2, 3, H3PO2, okay, means there is a one replaceable hydrogen, therefore it is what? Monobasic acid. What beta? Monobasic acid, your H3PO2, okay. Now, how your H3PO2 loses hydrogen and what they are giving us, okay? So see here, when this H3PO2, it gives a reversible reaction like this, H++, what beta? Yes, H2PO2 minus, okay. I hope you understood all about your first acid, that is phosphinic acid or hypophosphorus acid, that is your what? H3PO2, okay? So now we will discuss second, what are oxoacids of phosphorus, okay? So see here, what will be the our second one, that is orthophosphoric, okay, sorry, orthophosphorus acid. What beta? Second, orthophosphorus acid, or we can call it as a simply, phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid is what? Yes, H3PO3, orthophosphorus acid or phosphorus acid, okay? So these are what? Your H3PO3. Now in that, your phosphorus is what? Yes, phosphorus is in plus 3 oxidation state. Okay, now we will do a beta preparation of this here. How we can do the preparation? Say PCl3, okay? Say here, PCl3 plus H2O, that gives what? Yes, H3PO3 plus HCl. What beta? H3PO3 plus HCl. To balance the reaction, we need to balance with 3H2O. Okay? So here, as you know, it is a diprotic. Whatever the your H3PO3 is what? Diprotic. Now we can explain on the basis of its structure, as like this, P double bond is O, OH, here also OH, and here what? H. So it contains two replaceable H+ ion, therefore it is what? Diprotic. Or we can say we can call it as a diabasic acid. What beta? Diabasic acid. I hope you understood this. Now अभी हम dissociation की बात करें इसके. So we can dissociate act like this. H3PO3. So see here, they can dissociate H plus plus H2PO3 minus. Then again this beta H2PO3 minus, it will dissociate as like this. H plus plus HPO3 2 minus. Okay, again it will one more proton is here, so that's why what it will dissociate again. Okay, so what you will get, HPO3 2 minus, reversible sign, H plus plus what, yes, PO3 3 minus. Okay, I hope you understood this all. ठीक है, diabasic acid. Last we can discuss here what? Yes, after means here after what? Two protons are we can remove. ठीक है, now we will discuss the reaction also. H3PO3. So concentrate on this reaction. Okay, so see here. We already discussed this. So see, H3PO3 on heating, it gives what? Disproportionation reaction. So you will get what? Yes, you will get H3PO4 plus PH3. Means here beta plus 3 oxidation number. Here what? Plus 5. Here what? Beta minus 3. Means plus 3 to minus 3 decrease in oxidation number. Plus 3 to plus 5 increase in oxidation number. Therefore, it is what? An example of disproportionation reaction. Okay. So, we can balancing also this reaction. So, say, as like this, we can balance. Okay. Heating, so you can mention the temperature also 457 Kelvin. Okay. Now, it is so what all about your second example. Now we will discuss orthophosphorus acid. We discuss now orthophosphoric. Okay, orthophosphoric acid. That is your third one. Say third one. 1, 2, 3. Orthophosphoric acid. That is your H3PO4, or we can call it as a what? Only phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid. You must know this thing. Whatever names are very much important. From that names, you have to. Okay. You must know what will be the formula on the base of their name. Phosphenic H3PO2, orthophosphorus acid, what your H3PO3, or we can say only phosphorus acid. Now here what? Orthophosphoric, or we can say phosphoric acid is what? H3PO4. These are very much important acids all. Okay, now see here, we will discuss next preparation. What beta? How we prepare this our phosphoric acid? See here, when you are this PCl5 hydrolyze, then you will get what? Yes, you will get, as we know, so many times we discuss this reaction. So H3PO4 means same oxidation number wala, we will get a product. So here what? Phosphorus plus 5. So here also you will get what? Plus 5 plus HCl. So we can balance this. Cl5, so here 5 Cl. Again, okay. So here how much beta? Yes, here 4 H2O. Yes, understood this thing. So like that we can balance. Okay, so I hope you understood this, whatever preparation of your H3PO4. Okay, बेटा दिस इज वन ऑन हिटिंग ओनली यू विल गेन. ठीक है. नाउ ऑन द बेस ऑफ सपोज इफ यू आर थिंकिंग अबाउट बेस्ट सिटी, सो फॉर दैट बेस्ट सिटी वी नीड व्हाट? यस, वी नीड व्हाट? वी नीड स्ट्रक्चर. सो एज लाइक दिस OH, here also H, here also your OH. So basically these are what? Tri-basic acid. Now how it dissociates? Say H3PO4, okay, reversible with H plus plus what? H2PO4 minus, like this. Now again when this H2PO4 minus further, it will one more proton we can remove. Yes, what you will get? HPO4 2 minus. Okay, so here next, when HPO4 2 minus further, yes, you will get what, beta? H plus plus PO4 3 minus. Okay, I hope you understood this. Okay, means like that, it is what? Your tribasic acid. Understood. Now these are all about your phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4. Understood. Now here one more important we will discuss, that is 4 pyrophosphoric acid. Okay. See here, beta. Pyro phosphoric acid. What will happen regarding your pyro? Fourth one. Okay. Pyrophosphoric acid. So you can write beta their chemical formula also, that is H4P2O7. Pyrophosphoric acid. Okay. Now how it will prepare? So preparation reaction. First word beta, preparation reaction. So see here, when orthophosphoric acid is heated at about 523 Kelvin. Okay. Orthophosphoric acid is your what? H3PO4. When it heated at 523 Kelvin, then you will get what? Yes, H4P2O7 plus H2O. So for that we need to multiply by 2, then our reaction is balanced. So if you have any doubt regarding balance, you can immediately share. Okay. Okay. See here, these are what our reaction of about preparation of H4P2O7. So now we will say how will be the structure of this. So concentrate on beta here. ठीक है. सो सी यार, पी डबल बॉन्ड OH. ठीक है, हियर OH, हियर OH, H4P2O7. सो एज लाइक दिस, हियर OH आल्सो, हियर आल्सो OH. सो से H4 1 2 3 4, H4P2O7. सो हियर 3, हियर 3, 6 एंड 7. सो it is what? Tetrabasic acid. What beta? Tetrabasic acid. I hope you understood this. Okay. Now see one more remarkable reaction of our H4P2O7, that is what? Pyrophosphoric acid is what? Say you can write beta that reaction. When, see, we will write newly only about the reaction of pyrophosphoric acid. So when we heat this H4P2O7, then you will get what? Yes, you will get metaphosphoric acid at about 873 Kelvin. So see, act like this. When H4P2O7, when you heat strongly at 873 Kelvin, you will get what? HPO3 plus H2O. So this HPO3, we call it as a what? metaphosphoric acid. What beta? Metaphosphoric acid. Okay. Now these are what all about here for pyrophosphoric acid. Now our next acid is only what? Yes, next acid is our what? Metaphosphoric acid. So you concentrate on fifth acid. Okay. Metaphosphoric acid. Formula HPO3. Basically, this we call it as a what beta? It has a only one pOH bond, so it is a monobasic. Okay, but there it exists as a what? Polymeric form. So we will discuss first how this your metaphosphoric acid is prepared simply. So see here, when your H3PO4 is heated at 523 Kelvin, you will get what? HPO3 along with water. So see our reaction also balance. Yes, this is what your metaphosphoric acid. Understood? So it is basically, we can call it as a what? Monobasic acid. Suppose if you draw this much only, how much say, up to this much level, P double bond O, this O, okay, here OH, HPO3, so we can observe here one only hydrogen is replaceable, so it is what, monobasic acid, but it will exist, okay, does not exist as a simple monomer, it will exist as a what? Cyclometaphosphoric acid, or we can say polymetaphosphoric acid. It will not exist as a monomer simply. It will exist as a what? Cyclometaphosphoric acid. Cyclometaphosphoric acid, or we can say what? Polymetaphosphoric acid. Okay, so this condition you must know. Okay, now we will draw the structure, actual how it looks. Our okay, so see here, like that our structure, you concentrate on this structure. POP linkage as like this. Okay. Understood. So here what beta? Double bond O and OH. Here what? Double bond O and OH. Double bond O and OH. Take it. Cyclometaphosphoric. These are, we can call it as a trimetaphosphoric acid. What beta? Tri, or we can say cyclometaphosphoric acid. Okay, so in that, see, your phosphorus is valenced by five bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now how it will occur in our polymetaphosphoric acid? So say here, as like this, we can draw, say, P double bond O, OH, O, here also same, OH, O, as like this. Okay, like this we can write P, OH, double bond O. Okay, these are what beta? Your polymeta, yes, polymeta phosphoric acid, or we can mention like this formula, HPO3N. HPO3N. I hope you understood this all about your polymetaphosphoric acid, or we can say metaphosphoric acid. Okay. Now we will discuss some few examples of oxoacids of phosphorus. So So concentrate on this. Yes, H3PO5 we will discuss, beta. H3PO5, in that your phosphorus how much plus oxidation state. Okay. Try basic. See, we will draw the structure P double bond OH. Okay, this OH. Understood? Like this, peroxy monosulfuric acid. Sorry, mono phosphorus acid, not a sulfuric, because sulfur is not there. Here what? Phosphorus. Peroxy mono phosphorus acid. H3PO5. Or we can say 1, 2, 3. Three replaceable hydrogen. Therefore, these are what? Yes. Tri-basic. Okay. Now, hypophosphoric acid, H4P2O6. H4P2O6. Okay. Hypo, see, we can write her name. Hypophosphoric acid. So we can draw your structure, in that your phosphorus is having plus 4 oxidation state. So see here how it looks. P double bond O, OH, OH, okay, P double bond O, OH and OH. Total how much? Tetrabasic. For what, beta? Tetrabasic acid. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So see, your phosphorus also valence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Understood. One more we can mention here, H4P2O5. See here. H4P2O5. In that, your phosphorus is what? Yes. Phosphorus is in your plus 3 oxidation state. So we will draw here structure as like this. Here we will draw, beta. Say, concentrate on this. P double bond O, yes. H, okay. OH, say, O, P double bond O, H. And here what? OH, like that. What? Basically, it is what? Dibasic. So, dibasic acid it is. Understood? Phosphorus is in what? Plus 3 oxidation state. Okay. I hope you understood whatever this all. Any doubt related with this, you can ask anytime. Okay. So, hypophosphorus acid, all you know now. Okay. So we can write as a pyrophosphorus acid. Pyrophosphorus acid, that is H4P2O5. We can write the name also. Okay. I hope you understood these oxoacids of phosphorus. Okay. You need to revise this all. You have to do practice of these structures. If any doubt will come, you can ask free. Feel free to ask any doubts. Okay. So, thank you very much and all the best.